friends, good morning and welcome. We are going to start in a few minutes, about 2 minutes from now, so you're welcome to come in and take a seat, and we'll start in about 2 minutes. Thank you. Good morning once again and welcome to everybody. Baie welkom aan almal wat hier is vanoggend. Ons gaan vanoggend se verrigtinge in Engels doen terwyl van ons gaste wat nie Afrikaans verstaan nie. Dit is in liefde wat ons graag net almal wil laat welkom voel. And so if you don't understand Afrikaans, don't worry. The rest of the service, or most of it at least, will be in English so that you will also be able to understand what is being said this morning. We welcome everybody, and we're just going to give a few seconds for everybody to take a seat, and then we will start formally. There's still plenty of space in front, so please come on in. Friends, once again, now that everybody is inside, welcome. Welcome to the memorial service of Christine Brink. It is, however, more than simply a memorial service. It is a celebration of God's goodness to us in the life of Christine Brink. We are thankful to God to have known her, and we praise God for his goodness in her life to us. We are going to meet in God's name today, and before we do that, before we pray to God, I would like us to think about the character of God that has given us the privilege of knowing Christine. And so before I pray, I would just like to read a few verses from Psalm 145. Psalm 145 will be on the overhead projector, but it's also, all the scripture is on the little sheet on your chairs, and so please follow with me. This is the God that has been so kind to us to let us enjoy Christine's friendship. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. The Lord is good to all, and his mercy is over all that he has made. All your works shall give thanks to you, O Lord, and all your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and tell of your power, to make known to the children of man your mighty deeds and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations. The Lord is faithful in all his words and kind in all his works. The Lord upholds all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand, you satisfy the desires of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and kind in all his works. The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. Let's pray together. Lord, we draw near to you. We draw near to you with humble hearts and with a lot of sadness. Lord, we are so, we find it difficult, Lord, to express the pain that we experience as we say goodbye to Christine. But Lord, we are also hopeful and thankful. We are hopeful that she is in a better place right now. And we are thankful that you have given us the privilege of knowing her and enjoying a relationship with her. And so, Lord, we look to you today to give us hope, to give us comfort, to bring us comfort, and to strengthen us, Lord, and to give us an eternal perspective on life. And we pray and ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, we are now going to have an opportunity to praise God for his goodness as the band leads us in three songs that will be up on the overhead projector. There will be some Afrikaans, quite a lot of Afrikaans in that, but please do feel free to join in if you can.
Thanks, Elof. Familie en vrienden, staan saam met ons en sing ons hierdie drie liedere.
Thank you.
plek om te sit.
Morning, everyone. We'll be reading from Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 to 13. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. What gain has the worker from his toil? I have seen the business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity into man's heart, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. I perceive that there is nothing better for them than to be joyful and to do good as long as they live. Also, that everyone should eat and drink and take pleasure in all his toil. This is God's gift to man.
Thank you, Janne. Friends, we're just going to pray and ask God to be with us as we look at these words together. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for your word. We know your word is true and your word can strengthen us. It can build us up. Lord, we pray that you would quiet our hearts, that you would make us receptive to your voice, and that you would speak to us, Lord. Would you encourage us this morning? Would you speak to us from your word? And would you help us to leave this place with hope, eternal hope? And we pray and ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, as people, we are constantly busy. We are always working. We are always trying to create an environment when we and our loved ones can flourish. We are geared for progress. We work towards a goal. Humanity has made incredible progress from the time of creation. It is incredible what man has achieved in the years he's been on Earth. Driving here, it is incredible to look at the variety of cars on the road, and it is something that man has made. Look at your cell phone. It is incredible what a cell phone can do right now. Or look at medical science or artificial intelligence. What man can do is incredible. It really is remarkable what man has been able to achieve in the time that he's been on Earth. And yet there are certain things we have absolutely no control over. There are many things that we have no control over. And so Janne read for us from Ecclesiastes. It's a book in the Bible. It forms part of the wisdom literature of the Old Testament. And it is a teacher who speaks to us from Ecclesiastes. He helps us to understand life from a heavenly perspective. Very often we look at life only from what we can see. We look at life from an earthly perspective, but Ecclesiastes helps us to look at life from a heavenly perspective. If we look at life only from an earthly perspective, life can often feel meaningless. Nothing really satisfies, nothing lasts. We enjoy some good moments and then some bad, and then we die. If that is the way that we look at life, then we need to hear this message from the preacher, from Ecclesiastes. He helps us to look at life from an eternal perspective. He helps us to realize that what we see is not all that's going on. He helps us to see things the way that God sees things. And the things that God sees is eternal, and the things that God does lasts for all eternity. In Ecclesiastes 3, the teacher gives us a poetic list of things that we experience in life, but that we have no control over. We have absolutely no control over the basic things of life. Let's read verse 1 to 8 together again to feel the rhythm, the drumbeat of life that happens that we have no control over. So, Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather the stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to tear and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. These are things that we are to some degree familiar with, all of them, but we have no control over any of them. We have no control over when we're born, and we have no control over when we die. We can't determine the season to plant mealies. We can only discern the season to plant the mealies. If we plant mealies too early, if the season is not right yet, the mealies might be eaten by the birds and they might never yield a crop. Or if we plant too late, the mealie plants may never reach maturity because winter will come and it'll stop growing. And so there are things in life that we have no control over. The best that we can do is to discern the season and adapt. The good news for those who know God and who trust God is that God controls everything. God is in control of the times and the seasons that we experience. God is completely in control of everything, and everything works together for the good of those who love God. The teacher says it in verse 11. Let's read again from verse 10. I have seen the business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time. The birth of a baby is beautiful in its time. When God gives rain and the mealie field starts to become green as the new sprouts sprout out, it is beautiful. God makes everything beautiful in its time. And even death, however sad, can in God's goodness be beautiful. If we look at Christine's life from God's perspective, it is complete. She has done the things that God has called her to do, and it was time, according to God, to call her home. She raised her children well. Chris and Stefan said to one another in the hospital that they had it good. They had a good mother, and I'm sure Natasha would agree. She was a good mother. It is clear for all of us to see that her grandchildren loves her very much because she poured herself into them. She taught them, and so they love her because she loved them so much. Throughout the years, Christine opened her home to many people who needed a safe place to find their feet again. And so Christine has done the things that God has called her to do. From our earthly perspective, death is a horrible intruder. But from God's heavenly perspective, death has become a door to himself and a feast that he has prepared for us. For the believer who dies, it is a beautiful thing, even if it's heartbreaking for us who are left behind. We can take heart knowing that death is not the end. Verse 11 says, also, he has put eternity into man's heart. So what does it mean? What does it mean that God has put eternity into the heart of man? It means we are eternal beings, It means that our hopes and desires are eternal and our existence is eternal. It explains why death feels so abrupt, why death is such a sad thing. It is because death is not the end. That is why Jesus cried at death and we cry at death, because it feels like the end, but death is not the end. We are eternal beings. And being eternal means we know that we are eternal because nothing satisfies us in this life. We are never completely satisfied. We always long for more. And only the presence of God can truly satisfy our heart's deepest desires. And so death can be a beautiful thing if we understand that Christine's eternal desires is now being satisfied in the presence of a loving God and Savior. Jesus, who existed eternally before the creation, stepped into this world out of love to live the life that we couldn't live, the perfect life that we couldn't live. And he died a death in our place so that we can be reunited with the Father in his place. Through faith in Jesus, we can have access to God. In this life, God cares for everybody. It was clear from Psalm 145. Psalm 145 said, "He has mercy on all that he has made. He is faithful and kind in all his works." God is the one who satisfies the desires of every living thing. Jesus said he lets it rain on the believer and the unbeliever. But once we enter into eternity, we will get what we longed for. If we longed for existence away from God, we will get it. We will be separated for eternity from God and all his goodness. But if we love God and we trust in Jesus, our hearts will eternally be satisfied in his presence. None of us are beyond redemption. Jesus will not reject anyone who comes to him truly. And so there is time for us to come to Jesus as long as we are granted time. Chris told me on the day that his mother passed that Jesus was my mother's rock. And that is a comfort not only to the family, but also to Christian friends who know that she is finally in the place where God created her to be, in his presence, enjoying his goodness for all eternity. Her eternal longings are now satisfied in the presence of our eternal God. And so I close by reading verse 12 and 13 that helps us to understand how we are to live right now in the shadow of our own approaching death. Verse 12 says, "I perceive that there's nothing better for them than to be joyful and to do good as long as they live. Also, that everyone should eat and drink and take pleasure in all his toil. This is the gift of God to man." How are we to live? We are to live as if life is a gift from God, a gift to be enjoyed, where God calls us to fulfill the purposes and the tasks that he has given us, and to live with gratitude for God's goodness until he calls us home. Because when we go to be with God, to be in his presence, we will, our hearts' deepest desires will be fully satisfied in the presence of our loving God. Let's pray together. Lord, we thank you that we can know you. We thank you for the Lord Jesus and his sacrifice on the cross that paid the price for our sins, that we can be reunited to you. And we thank you that we could see in Christine's life that she loved you and that she was looking forward to being with you. Thank you that we can find hope knowing that she is now satisfied. She is not experiencing any pain anymore or sadness. And we have a certain hope that we will join her once we come to you. Lord, we thank you for your goodness. We pray that you would strengthen and comfort us and that you would lead us in your ways. And we ask it in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Friends, I would like to thank Matemi and friends who made the little video for us of Christine. And we're now going to have an opportunity for Matemi and Amurei to say something. And Stefan will join them and also have a few words, after which Chris will come and do some thank yous.
Hello, our names are Amurei and Matemi. We're here today
to celebrate our Oma.
She was the strongest person we knew.
That was the biggest thing we loved about her.
She was loved by everyone here today.
We wish she was still here with us.
She spoiled us with love and gifts. We wish we could repay her.
She was always there for our ups and our downs.
She always wanted the best for us. We are so grateful for her love.
We will miss her, but she will always be in our hearts.
Her chips were so good and she always made them with love.
It was always nice to talk to her over the phone.
She planned to work 8 more years and her accents were so funny. And she always talked French with the worker and Afrikaans with the French fam back in Paris.
It was so sad what happened that day.
But at least we got to see each other again because we saw each other 5 years ago.
Thank you all for coming here today to celebrate our Oma.
Today we are here to celebrate the life of Marie Christine Brink, also known as our Oma. She was the strongest woman we knew and always spoiled us with gifts. We don't know how to repay her. She was always grateful for what she had, and all of us loved her so much. Now can we all bow our heads for a prayer? Lord, I thank you that you made Marie Christine Brink our Oma. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you all for coming.
Hi everyone, morning everyone. I'm Stefan, Christine's youngest son. I've been given the privilege to have say a couple of words about our mothers and their life. I'll start off with a quote from Martin Luther King, who said, "Life's most persistent and urgent question is what you are doing for others." And this is a fitting quote about Christine's life. She was the most selfless person I've ever known. She once told a friend that she was put on this earth to help others, and that she did, from the day I can remember. From being part of Action 2819, where they spread the word of Jesus Christ and handed out food parcels in the rural communities, to her clients, where she always ensured they get the best she can offer. Her persistence to make a success of everything she took on is something I admired about her most. It didn't matter how many obstacles life thrown at her, and there were many. She always stood up and kept going until she succeeded. She grew up in a small town called Lucre in France, where she drove rally cars. That does explain her driving skills, as you could hear her car from a mile away when she came to visit. She immigrated to South Africa at the age of 21. Couldn't have been easy moving to a foreign country where she didn't know anybody and couldn't speak any of their languages. She had to learn Afrikaans and English, but never let the French in her go. A call from her mom was, as always, started in French, and there was no point in trying to stop her until she finished the sentence. There are many stories I could tell about how tough and resilient she was. Her mode of transport was always a talking point. I will never forget her barking skills when picking us up from school. It always had to be parked on a downhill slope for in case it didn't start. We had to push start it. but for her, a car wasn't important. The most important thing in her life was to ensure children was looked after. She always ensured that we had a roof over our heads and food for us to eat. We never went to bed hungry, and doesn't matter who walked through that door, she would always make them feel at home and welcome to stay as long as they'd like. She was resilient till the day she passed away by never giving up on a life, even in hospitals, where the doctor couldn't explain how she survived so long and had to do some extensive research about her case. Her family was everything to her, and keeping us together as a close family was a priority, and that she did. She ensured we all stayed connected by arranging braais or barbecues and family gatherings and holidays with our family from France, who has joined us here today to say our final goodbyes. She leaves behind a loving family and people all around the world that will miss her greatly and love her forever with the fondest memories. As we bid her farewell to Christine, we find solace in knowing that her faith was a guiding light through her life's journey. We take comfort in the belief that Christine is now reunited with our Creator, basking in the eternal joy and peace of her presence. May her spirit continue to shine bright in our hearts, reminding us of all the power of faith, love, and promise of everlasting life. Rest in peace, Mom, until we meet again, and embrace of our Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Stefan, Martemi, Nathan, Omurai. I just want to give a few thanks for people in this, especially in this last, let's say, month. Sorry. I think I want to, let me start with saying thanks to Ilse Marie van Staden, who was a doctor. Thanks, Ali. that she submitted her or asked that she be taken to emergency. She saw it wasn't the diabetes, but actually it was a there was heart problems. And as difficult as it was for Mom, you know, she didn't want to go back. But she went to Kloof, and they were really amazing with her, even though they don't have a cardiology department. They calmed her. And then she was taken to Zuid-Afrikaans, and I must say I'm so thankful. for the way they treated her. Sorry, I'll get going now, okay? the way they treated her, the sisters, the doctor, they really loved her. He never got the idea that this was just a job. I'm so thankful for that, even if they had to do stuff that she didn't like. They still did it in a loving way, and I appreciate that very much. I also want to add in them going out of their way to to help for Stefan and Linnell to get a letter so that they could come from New Zealand. So they really went the extra mile, and we are so thankful for them. The way they cared for her in the sense that they washed her hair when she couldn't. They put cream on her hands, so her hands was always soft. And they really, really went out of the way. So we're very thankful for that. Then we just want to thank. I don't know what the English is. Begrafnis ondernemer. I'll translate that to you later when I get the word Korean. But the undertaker, that's it. Thank you very much for the way that you handled this, and also for Stefan and Marco for standing up in that and doing that. It's very much appreciated. And then we want to thank Lichtpunt, or everyone involved here. Thank you for the music team that took off from work. Vili, Nina, everyone there, Natali, I nearly forgot your name. But thank you very much. Thank you for that. Natasha van Sail. And of course, Hendrik on the drums. It's probably because he's sitting at the back. Also, Natasha, thank you very much. It's really a privilege to have you in our lives. And that you were in her lives as well, Fish. And that's not his real name. But Fish, thanks for the sound, and also for Rainer at the projector. And then Yelof, thank you for taking the sermon and doing it not in your mother tongue. Thank you for that. Then I think in general we just want to thank everyone for all your messages that you sent to us. We appreciated it. Even when she was sick, after she was not with us, and even people coming from far, I think about Pierre, who was one of those people, and Vian staying with her. we appreciate that. I also want to thank Esther for the coffee. That we've been able to enjoy. And then also the food, Anke. Thank you very much for that as well. I think I've got, then I also want to thank Tania Lett. Thank you very much. I think for all the support that you gave us. I'm not so happy about the extra emails, but but I do appreciate it. Thank you very much. I also want to say thank you, and Corinne, please, for all the family that's in France. Thank you for you for coming. And Jewel, thank you for coming. Please, for all the family that's in France. I think if I had one wish for her, she always said she's going to work another 6 years, and then she's going to go for a long visit in France. And that's one thing that I wished for her, that she could spend more time with you, with all her family there. Thanks, Ali. I think Madeleine, thank you very much for you as well, for helping us. And then Taniria, thank you for looking after the children, the Bartaminis. We appreciate that also very much. And I just want to close off with, Tasha Blome, thank you very much for the flowers. I want to close with thanking all of you for loving her and loving us in this time. I think one big thing that I take away from this is that she was loved, and that in the end, my last thought was, what more do you want from life than being loved by those around you? And then the last one is, I just want to say thank you, Jesus. I think for the way she went, that we could be there, that Stefan could be here, and looking forward to seeing her again. And I still hope that I'll be a son by the time I see her again. Thank you.
Just a few notices before we close. Once we've done the benediction, the family will come forward. Please stand up when the music starts. The family will come forward and take Christine out to the vehicle that'll take her away. And then once they've taken her out, you can proceed out. There's flowers for you to take and to put on the coffin, in the vehicle, and as a final goodbye. And so I'm going to end off by reading a few verses from Isaiah 25. Isaiah 25, verse 6 to 9, is a picture of heaven. The mountaintop is the place where heaven and earth meet, and it is the place where we can enjoy God. It's the place where we, it's a symbolic picture of us being united to our Savior. And so this is what we've got to look forward to, and where Christine is already moved in advance of us. So Isaiah 25:69 says, "On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, a rich food of marrow, of aged wine well refined. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever, and the Lord will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people will be taken away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken, it will be said on that day, behold, this is our God, we have waited for him, that he might save us. This is the Lord, we have waited for him, that let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation." Amen. Please stand as the family prepares to take Christine out. Thank you very much. The undertaker has asked that if someone with a double cab, white Ford Bucky parked somewhere there, it obstructs his access and he won't be able to leave. So please, if you have a Ford white double cab, thank you, please move it. And then you are now, you are invited to please take some flowers and put it on the coffin in the car, and then you are invited to enjoy refreshments with the family. Thank you very much for coming today.